my channel, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you the fragrances that I am no longer in love with. I will be doing a couple of videos this year sharing my entire fragrance collection and of course some hauls and all that great stuff that I normally do, but I wanted to be real with you and share with you guys the fragrances that I'm just not here for anymore and things that I will probably be parting with shortly. So if you'd like to see those items, please keep watching. So I decided to do this video because I've been getting quite a lot of fragrance recently. I've been working with a fragrance company and I've been buying fragrance. I've been gifted fragrance. You guys know if you watch my fragrance videos that I love a good scent. I have so many wonderful people in my life who are sharing their favorite scents with me. So it's like I'm always in the market for a new scent. I know, story of my life. I'm always in the market for something. But as I'm getting a lot more fragrance, I've probably gotten like 10 this year. I think it's important to kind of go through my collection and scale back a bit and give away and sell and throw away things that are old, I don't like, and that don't work for me. So today I'm going to be sharing the first batch of things that I'm just no longer loving and how I kind of go about deciding things that I want to part with. A couple of these fragrances I have already gotten rid of, I've given them away, and I think I sold one or two. So I'm going to talk about those first. But I do want to tell you some of the ways I realize that I'm no longer into fragrance. One thing I'm starting to do now is wear fragrance every day. In the middle of the day when I'm working from home, wear fragrance to bed. When you have a sizable fragrance collection and you have the type of lifestyle where you don't leave the house too often, sometimes you find that you have all these great fragrances but there's no real need for them because you're not really leaving the house too much. So what I'm starting to do is really wear fragrance every day, all day, and even to bed. And wearing fragrance to bed, that's like the best indicator of whether or not I'm still into something or whether or not it still matches like my aesthetic and my style and everything like that. Because I wore one of these fragrances to bed last night and I woke up like wanting to gag because it smelled so gross on me with all my warmth that happened through 8 hours of sleeping. So that's one thing that I am starting to do and it is helping me so much. I've also just been going back over my collection and seeing what are the things I really love and then looking at the things that I have that I don't reach for that often and seeing if it's something that I need to just start using more or if it's just really not my style anymore. And a lot of these just aren't my style anymore or I just never really used them to begin with. They're still nice scents. This video is in no way bashing these brands or these fragrances. It's just not something that I'm into right now and I probably will be parting ways with all of these. So let's get into the scents that I have parted with, that I have gotten rid of, and that are no longer a part of my collection at all. The first one I'm going to talk about is Chanel Chance. Now this is the Chanel Chance Eau Tender or Tender or something. It's the pink liquid. It's the chance that is very, very popular. I believe I got that back in high school and I loved it at the moment, and it's very like fresh and floral and light and feminine, but to me it's just way too common. I like to have scents that are intoxicating and that are a little bit different so that when I'm next to someone and they smell me, they're like, wow, that smells amazing, I've never tried that before. I find that a lot of these scents, they're just too normal and generic smelling to me. I mean, we've all smelled a nice floral, and while some of these scents are really nice, that Chanel Chance is just way too generic for my liking. It's still a beautiful scent, but I don't know, I'm just really not into it. And I have Bond Number 9 Madison Square Park, I believe, and that smells like a fancier version of it. So there was really no need for me to have two, so I did give that bottle to my cousin. The second one that I got rid of is actually another Chanel, and it is the Signature Chance in the like amber liquid or something like that. I got rid of that one a few years ago because I don't know, I purchased it in college. Well, one, it was old, and two, I wasn't using it. It just wasn't my style anymore. It's a little too dark and musky without having like any sweetness in it. I really loved it when I wore it, which is so odd because I was wearing it when I was like 20 or 21-ish, and now I can't stand it. So that Chanel Chance is just definitely not the vibe anymore. It's way too dark without having any sweetness to it. I do like muskier scents, but they have to have like a little something extra, like a sweet note or a citrus note. It has to have something that brings about the feminine qualities in it, because that's like my style. And so that Chanel Chance just didn't work with me, so I got rid of that. The third one that I got rid of is one that I recently got, kind of recently. It's the Gucci Memoir. Now, this is one that I love. It's not that I don't love it. I got rid of it. I actually sold it because it just didn't last long enough on me. I love the scent of it. It was very like fresh and herbal and green, and it reminded me of springtime or even fall. And I don't know, it just didn't last enough on me, and I don't like having fragrances in my collection that I have to refresh every few hours, because if I do go out, I'm not gonna wanna carry the bottle with me. So that was one that I had to part with. I think when I purchased it, I posted about it on my Instagram and I explained that I love the scent, but I wasn't sure if I was gonna keep it just because the lasting power wasn't that great. And ultimately, I decided to part with it because I don't know, it really doesn't last on me, and I'm sure I could have gotten a rollerball, but then I'm spending like way over $100 on a scent that still really doesn't have good lasting power. So that was unfortunately one that I also had to get rid of. And I think the last scent that I can remember that I got rid of was Bond Number 9 Fire Island. And this was a scent that smells a lot like suntan lotion. And after a while, it just kind of made my stomach hurt. So that was the reason why I got rid of it. I am still in the market for a good like creamy suntan scent for the summertime, but I'll probably get like Bobbi Brown Beach or Replica to the Beach or something like that. I'll probably get those options. That one, I don't know, something about it just made my stomach hurt, so I did end up selling that one. So that is gone from my collection, and I believe those are the only four that I've gotten rid of that I can remember. So now let's get into the ones that I still do have in my collection, but that will be leaving soon. The first one is an oldie but goodie. You guys, this is my Marc Jacobs Daisy Oh So Fresh. She is such a good scent, you guys. She's beautiful, she's sweet. This always smells like really clean and sweet laundry detergent. Like, have you ever had somebody walk by and you can just tell that their mom did their laundry because it just smells so fragrant? I love that sometimes, it just smells so good. Well, this is what that reminds me of. It's not that I don't like it anymore, it's just not my vibe anymore. It's too like comfortable for me, you know? I like my scents to be to have a little something on the edge, you know? Just a little something sprinkled in, and this is just too safe. I will see if somebody in my life likes this, or I don't know, but I definitely won't be keeping this. For one, it takes up way too much space and I'm not reaching for it. Once again, it's not that I don't like it, it's just not a favorite anymore. The next one is another oldie but goodie, and this is Dolce & Gabbana Pour Femme. This is one that is a favorite of mine in the fall, but I never reach for it. It smells like raspberries. It has a little bit of a musk tone to it. It's deep, it's sweet and sexy, but it's still kind of safe. I like this one, but I don't use it enough. And it's not like it takes up a lot of space, so I probably could keep it. But I just wanted to let you guys know that your girl is not in love with this fragrance anymore. I like the scent, but I'm not in love with it. And for some reason, I never use it because it's still almost full. But it is a lovely scent. It's just not my favorite. I just find that now I'm getting more into scents that are more like, oh my gosh, so good, that the ones that I'm not really in love with, they just take up space and they can be gotten rid of. The next one is another one that I've gotten semi-recently. I probably got this one about 2 years ago, and this is Narciso Rodriguez, and this is called Narciso. This is the creamy white bottle. Now, this is like a spicy floral, like an oriental. It kind of smells like powder. It's very spicy and oriental. It's weird because it kind of smells like a little old lady, but like a cute, sophisticated, classy old lady. I'm just not in love with it anymore. I do like it. I probably need to wear it a little more this month. This is one that I got because I really loved at the time, so maybe I will reach back into this one, but the bottle is like 98% full. So what does that tell you? But smelling it, I do like it, so maybe I will dip back into her. My next one is Theret Mugler Alien. And this is, once again, 98% full. This one is very interesting. It definitely has some licorice tones in it. It smells very sweet and dark and mysterious. Sometimes when I wear this, it kind of makes my stomach hurt. This is one that I will absolutely be getting rid of because I just don't wear it enough to warrant keeping it. And it's one of those scents where when I got it, I liked it because it was so interesting. But sometimes it's a little too interesting and it makes my stomach hurt. But it really is a nice scent. It's just, I don't need to keep it anymore because I'm not using it. But how cute is the bottle? It looks like a little alien. Okay, my next scent is the one that I was talking about earlier. I actually wore this to bed last night. This is Jo Malone Nectarine Blossom and Honey. This just smells way too safe and generic. I wore it to bed last night and I was like, it's kind of cute. But then I woke up and wanted to gag because it just doesn't mix well with my chemistry. It just smells more sour on me and it gets very warm. I don't know, it's not my favorite. I may give this to one of my friends because I know she likes this scent. I may send this to her, but yeah, this one definitely has to go. It's way too safe. It does nothing for me. It doesn't bring out anything beautiful that's already in my skin chemistry. Yeah, it's a nice scent. It just does nothing for me. So she's gotta go. And my last one that I'm gonna talk about is one that I just saw my girl Happy Stylish Mommy talk about, and I feel the same exact way, and she is Bond Number 9 Park Avenue South. Now, the thing about this scent is, it's like you want to keep it just because of the bottle. It's so cute. I'm definitely going to keep this scent. I love Bond Number 9 bottles. They're so comfortable to hold. They're very beautiful. Exhibit A. But this scent, it smells like green apple. It's very, very light. It does smell a little sour, but like a sour green apple, of course. It's pretty, but it doesn't last long. This is another one of those scents that just has zero lasting power on me. I would probably have to respray this like every hour. And when I first got it, that wasn't a problem, but I never reach for it anymore. It's almost full. So I'm thinking, should I sell it or should I keep it? I don't know, but this is definitely one that I do not wear because it does not last on me. However, the bottle is incredibly beautiful. It's also very odd because out of all the other Bond Number 9 scents that I've tried that I've owned, I think I've had like 6 or so. They all last amazingly, but this one, it just, I don't know what happened. Maybe it was just the way it was made, but this is definitely one that I'm probably gonna keep because of the bottle and it's so cute, but I will never repurchase this. I could probably just go get a generic green apple scent and be happy. Like, I wanna say this was like $330. Way too expensive for a scent that you have to reapply every hour. I just can't do it. So yeah, guys, those are my top picks of the fragrances that I am no longer in love with. Let me know down below if you feel the same way about some of these scents, or even what are some scents that you once loved that you just can't get with anymore. I think it's important to go through all your categories of things that you collect or have a lot of, maybe even once a year, just to assess, like, is it your style? Does it fit your vibe? Is it something you're still wearing? Can you see yourself getting more use out of it in the future? Or do you just need to get rid of it because it's collecting dust and taking up space? And I've really been doing that. I've been doing that with my closet, with my shoes, with my handbags, and now I'm doing it with my fragrances, and I'm freeing up space, which means I'm gonna get more. But it's really nice to just simplify your collection for once and really just take a note of the things that you're no longer feeling, because now you can make better decisions when you are buying new fragrances. You know that, hey, I might not like something that's so simple and safe. Let me go for something a little different. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave any comments and questions you have down below, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.